Buckling analysis of a cylinder under external pressure. Hey dear viewer, this is Ronald speaking, and in this video I will take a look at a subscriber request. In this video I will take a look at a cylindrical shell which is loaded under external pressure. The shell has the following geometry and material parameters and is based on this article. Okay, first we go to Abacus and then we will create the model. First, you create a linear purification analysis model. Go to part shell extrusion. Continue. Create circle, center and perimeter. First point 0, 0. Okay. Next point is 500 and 0. Done, and the length is 1250. Okay, then we will create some planes. It's 6 to 5, and then those planes. Then we will cut the shell. Property material, create steel, mechanical, elasticity, elastic, then create a shell section, homogeneous, thickness is 1 millimeter, then section assignment manager. Fine assembly. Then we go to step, create linear perturbation buckle. Let's look at the first 10 eigenvalues. Okay, we go to load, create simply supported edges. I press shift and mouse. Oh no, let's start again. Here I select the shell, the whole shell. Then I press shift and mouse and SD key and mouse. The whole shell and then SDRG and mouse. And then I have only the edges. Okay, it's simply supported. So and then a pressure load brown 1. Okay, this looks okay. Mesh. I don't know. 20. No, that's too few. I always aim to have about 20,000. That's in my experience enough. Oh yeah, that's okay. Okay, I think that's it already. Create LBA. Okay, now we create the geometrically nonlinear analysis step. Replace general rigs. And here we have to select pressure. And create another file. I have here a Python script which I can use to map geometric imperfections onto a shell surface. And let's have a look where it is. Here it is. Let's have a look at the imperfection patterns. I think we have this pattern, this, 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 and this. Okay, and I think I'm not sure how many welds the shell has, but I think one is enough, so we will take this pattern. This is pattern 5. I have already input all the symmetry data, the length, the radius, the thickness. Here's the number of nodes, and so on. And then I press on this one. It takes a while to create the okay, now it's ready. Now I have created this following imperfection pattern and mapped it onto nodes. Then I take the here's the node file. Go to Abacus, create a new cylinder pressure. And I copy here the notes. This input file and those element files. Then I have to edit the file. Copy the name and then can I change? Yeah, I think it's fine. Save. Okay, file import model cylinder pressure input. Now here we have the model. I have to change some stuff. Assembly is already there. Step static, I know. Replace with X. I will perform the analysis and I will see you in the next part again. Okay, in this part we will look at the results. First, some small corrections need to be made in the GNA model. We have to go to Field Output Request Manager under Step and then under Forces and activate pressure loads. I think that we did the same for the GNA. Yes. And in the GNA we need to apply a small imperfection. I use just a small radial locking of a node here at the middle. I just selected this geometric vertice and locked the displacement in the U1 direction. That's a small imperfection we need for the analysis. Okay, now let's look at the results. Here we have the linear bifurcation analysis results. Here we have the buckling mode, and you can see that the pressure, the linear buckling pressure is about 0.02 MPa. Megapascals. And here are the other buckling modes. Okay, now let's have a look at the geometrically nonlinear analysis. Let's have a look at the pressure. We go to here element phase, and then we just select one node, plot, and then we can go to here, pressure, this one, and we can see that we have a pressure of about 0.02058. Stuff. Okay, and this is buckling behavior. Yeah. Okay. Here, is this here in this position we have the small displacement perturbation, and the buckling pattern starts here, the initial buckling starts at the opposite side. I don't know, can we link the viewports? Okay, doesn't seem to work, but okay. Ah. No? Okay, doesn't seem to work for RigsMest. But you can see here the buckling mode. Okay, now let's look at the results for the nonlinear analysis with geometric imperfections. Can stay here, GNA. Here we have a weight imperfection. Which starts at this side. And we can also take a look at the pressure. Um, see the buckling propagation. And here the pressure value is 0.018. Okay, then the next, what you can also do is we use the analytical equation for the buckling pressure. An equation I found was this one, which depends on the elasticity modulus, radius, and the length and the thickness. And if we use all the values, and we can determine an approximate value, which is smaller than the geometrically nonlinear and linear bifurcation analysis values. We have a comparison here. Here, this is the test buckling pressure. This is the buckling pressure from the linear bifurcation analysis, GNA. Here is geometric imperfections. Here is another knockdown factor for external pressure, which is only 0.9. And here LBA with another knockdown factor, and here the analytical knockdown factor. You can see the results. If you use another knockdown factor or the analysis with geometric imperfections, we can calculate a conservative estimation for the test buckling pressure. And you can see here the shell after the final buckling event. Yeah, okay, that's it for this part. Okay, what I also did is I created an account on GitHub and I uploaded the input files for the video from today. The links will be in the download description. It works like this. You click on the download link and then here, this will be the download link. And then you click on download. And you can STGA, STGC, copy the whole content, then you go to, I don't know, some of the dictionaries, create a new text file, new text, call it like this, no. Copy the whole stuff and paste and then save the file. And then I think you should let's rename it for testing. You can go to Abacus, file import part. No. File import model. And then click on the file you just created. Yes, and it works. And then you can use the files from the video. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.